Hello, and today on Art with Nikki Neustar, we have a canvas, and today we will be doing art, because that is what Art with Nikki Neustar is all about. Art, you may be aware of, is hugely powerful imagery and creativity in some form of workable substance by the works of man. It's very clever, really. And there's a scale, there's degrees, there's a huge spectrum of quality of art with people like Michelangelo, Spielberg at the top, and then you whittle all your way down to probably Tracy Emin at the bottom or something like that. Yeah, she's worth a lot of money, but is it any good? Is a soiled bed displaying her sheer, whatever the word would be for her, ennui at the time, to be polite about my sheer exasperation, desperation of being a drunken old slapper. But no wonder she's gonna just have a rant against the system. But if you've actually bothered to listen in class at school and got your little noggin going about all the good stuff that an education system offers, you might realise we're living in very interesting and possibly dangerous times. And therefore the Art with Nikki Neustar programme is here to help you and make you understand why the wokerati are such a dangerous movement in culture. Let's see if we can get this right, shall we? First of all, here is the canvas. I hope it doesn't offend you. It is white. I'm white. Racist? You might think so. Is it? Canvas has to be painted something. It's not even painted as its natural colour after it's been put through the system and created. Bleached, whatever. But they're always usually white, aren't they? Is that racist? Should we start making black canvases, or brown canvases, or yellow canvases, or red canvases, so we can be neutral gender frequency specific, or whatever the term is these days for being really quite satanic and crap. Jesus, I've done enough already. Right, let's get on with this. Now, this is the point of the whole video. I've waffled on far too long, but now we're getting to the point. We're going to create a politically correct work of art. Well, there's only one politically correct colour that I can think of in life without causing too much controversy and also adding a little spice of excitement. However, if I was to use my golden spray can upon this canvas, it might spread over onto my green screen, right? Which really I do not want to happen, okay? So I'm only going to use this very sparingly. Right, now, we've created the beginnings of a piece of art. Two gold dots. They almost resemble eyes crying, don't they? That's almost, as it currently stands, an animated canvas, in that the paint is dripping in actual, living, physical motion down the canvas as we speak. Isn't that incredible? Okay? So you've witnessed something real here tonight. Fluid art in motion, okay? But I don't want to leave it there because, you know, that's a nice canvas that cost me some money. I don't want to leave it like that. But, and also, crying eyes might make people feel a bit sad. Oh, there you go. They're not very defined, are they? So let's define them. Got my colours here. Oh, dear. It's been such an arduous existence. Right, now, I haven't got a thick black. Which is probably a good thing, because you might think that was racist, right? Or not, because I haven't got one. You might think that's racist, you know? So we have to be able to use the word of colour for colour without it being deemed a political slur upon anyone's good nature. Do you understand? Banning words just because they resemble things that you're uncomfortable with is not right. However much you feel uncomfortable with it, it's just ridiculous. We've already been through this throughout culture many times. Words have been banned in the past. Certain words we don't use in the modern world, I think you can think of a few, are not the first examples of words being omitted from the general lexicon of the cultural language. Many of those words which have been omitted were biblical. And that should tell you something about modern society, my friends. So what I'm going to do, I think blue being the colour of the sky, and the sea is one way of looking at things. I don't think we can go wrong with offending too many people with blue, because blue isn't really the colour of any of us unless we're suffering from hypothermia. And blue is the colour of eyes as well. We all like blue eyes. Oh no. People with blue eyes are better than people with brown eyes or black eyes. Or whatever eyes. But it doesn't really matter. But the thing is, to make eyes of that is almost a bit of a cliche. So I want to do something slightly different. Now, that's all it is. Two colours, two effects, two principles, two concepts. And already, it's looking really quite interesting, isn't it? Now, where could we go from there? Wow. I know another bright colour that isn't generally associated with the colour of people's epidermis. And this, of course, you're racist. Which I'm not. So I'm going to opt for the colour red. Colour red now. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. Already we're off to a flying start. We've hardly used any of the canvas. We've used three colours, none of them racist. And we have what is that? It's, I suppose that looks a bit like a dagger with testicles for a whatever that part of the dagger is called, I forget. Please write in the comments below if you're wise enough to remember. So, but what is it? I don't know. It just looks symmetrical, it looks aesthetically pleasing given what I started with. Let's embellish it a bit more, shall we? Now I've made a fatal error in that very difficult process. The symmetry, as you can now see, is hugely compromised compared to the original image we have. Originally, the symmetry, apart from the gold precision of the flex, was pretty much spot on, even though it was fairly rudimentary as it was done quickly by hand. However, in this example, in order to be symmetrical, I had to do exactly the same on the left as I did on the right, but flipped, and by my eye, I'm almost doing it backwards in order to do it. It's not quite right, but that's how it feels like. And it's quite hard to do, and I haven't done it very well. I'm sorry about that. I am not a great artist. My friend, what's her name, Rachel in America, is a genius. Now, I've used a bit too much red. I'm getting tired of it, so I'm going to change the colour. Now, none of us are green, and the grass is green. I don't think we can complain about the grass. Unless you're completely free. Can we use the word free? No. Okay, completely off kilter, not brilliant, but you get the general idea. Now what is that? That is something, isn't it? It's not racist. It's not offensive. It's not even, is it offending anyone out there? Is anyone offended? Well, I hope not. And it wasn't intended to offend. It was just to teach you the basics of creativity and art. So let's have a look. There's so much more we could do here. We can expand in every which way we can, just to create an awesome image, and it will take me ages to fulfill to its true level of required need. So I'll leave it there. But the point is, do I put some black in or not? Because leaving black out, and black is vital to art, right? It almost feels like it's racist not putting some black in. Right? So I'm gonna put some black in to prove racism is a nonsense. Shit! That freaked the shit out of me. Was that a god? Yes, that's a god. Who knows? Maybe he doesn't want me to put the black in. Maybe he wants me to keep it pure and point out that by not putting some black in the painting, it's not racist. But then it would look good with some black, wouldn't it? It really would. Oh. I'm confused now. Oh, okay. So what I'm going to do is put in some black, proving that I'm not racist. Let's do this. And no, I'm not going to deal with some of you naughty people are thinking. I tell you so much, when it comes to using black in art, the power of black in art is to create shade, therefore depth of field, light, dark. Okay, the antithesis of white. The black, dark. That's nothing to do with the colour of our skins. We're just born different cultures, okay? And we're affected by the sun's rays over long historical periods of epidermis buildup physiology. The point is that black is a vital colour and we have to be able to call things what they are. So I'm going to put in a little picture. No, I can't be asked because I don't want to ruin it. And anything now feels forced. And I'm happy with that as beginning, and I don't want to spoil my image by putting something black on it just because I want to point out that it's not racist, right? But then I don't want to leave the image as it is, having pointed out that black is not racist, because that might make people think I'm racist by not putting in any black when I could have done. Not to mention the emphasis of white and the absence of any black. That could be seen as racist if you were completely lunatic. Which I feel like people are out there, brother. So anyway, I think I know what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm going to try something. What I'm going to do is rectify where I made the error by using super colour black. And there, ladies and gentlemen, we have an increasingly advanced image. So still rudimentary in its early days, but as you can see in less than 20 minutes, we've created an image I think you will remember, given the scope of information that led up to developing it. It wasn't intended to look like this, and I'm reminded of the pointy bird from Steve Martin's films. Pointy bird, upon my head, a 1990, pointy bird, and that's wrong, but it's something like that. And it's looking like a bird's face now, isn't it? With a beak and its eyes here and its tufts up here and its bits of its mouth around there. Its jaw, if birds have jaws. Do they? Does the bird have jaws? But there we are. So I could be here all night, and frankly, I could go to town on this and it would look pretty cool at the end. But really, the point of this, try and make the world's first wholly non-political, totally politically correct, woke-erotic pleasing, Nazi pleasing, gay, lesbian, herbivore, sexual, whatever, pleasing, every Pope pleasing, Buddha pleasing, communist pleasing, anti-artist movement pleasing. Anyone, can this one image please everyone on planet Earth? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I believe it can.